In this simulation, we calculate enthalpy and entropy properties for real gases and then calculate their differences to get departure functions. And so the example here is plotting, I've selected carbon dioxide, so I can select one of three gases, or I could compare them all at one pressure. And if I select enthalpy, then my choices are to display enthalpy or the enthalpy departure function. So if I select entropy, then this will change to entropy. And I can change the pressure and look at the differences between the two. As the pressure gets higher, we expect the enthalpy, for example, to deviate more from the ideal gas. So the only variable here that we can change with sliders is the pressure. So let's look at this simulation and look at the behavior. So here's the simulation, and you can see we can select either enthalpy or entropy, and then we can change the gas, or we can compare all the gases, but now this is just at one pressure. Let's go back and look at carbon dioxide. I can change the pressure, and the enthalpy, of course, for your ideal gas doesn't change, but for the real gas, as the pressure gets higher, the deviation is larger. The difference between these two is the departure function, so the departure function is plotted here, and notice there's difference in scales between these two. Entropy, as I change the pressure, notice that, of course, the ideal gas also depends on pressure, entropy of an ideal gas, so they both change, but the difference between the two becomes larger as it go to higher pressures or as it go to lower temperatures where it's less ideal. So hopefully this gives a little better understanding of what we mean by departure functions and how we obtain them.